Today is day one of working with my 2022 Fort Worth Makeover horse. As you saw, got the halter put on him in the lead rope, which I'm not really sure why I got the lead put on. I never do. I think it was just like I was in my tack room and it was a habit and I grabbed it. So he's got a halter and lead on, kind of. He changed his mind. I thought we were going to get a faster start and he had different plans. But it's okay. We're going to work with it. I'm going to work right now on the normal pressure and release, kind of matching his footfall, his footsteps, and seeing if I can get him to reach out and touch this a few times. I think my goal is to get that halter back over the ear today. I don't know how I'm going to do that quite yet. I kind of got to gauge where my horse is at and how he's feeling about things, but I don't want to push it too far because I really want the halter back on and make sure I always reward him when he is trying harder and giving more. But let's get started. Definitely a talker too. Like I've heard him when we're just walking around still in the paddock for other reasons, and he's always snorting. The other thing about the lead is he keeps stepping on it and I feel bad. I feel like when I'm working with him, it might hold him back a little bit when he literally is holding himself back. Good boy. So I want to be careful about this. Gives me a little bit of a roulette vibe for those of you that watched my 2020 Player's Choice horse. That's the only thing with like working with draw. I haven't decided if I'm the biggest fan of working with draw with these new guys yet. It's almost better to push away or kind of just wait for them to come up to you, I guess. Draw sometimes is a little bit worrisome when they come at you at that like quicker pace, but he still turns away and wanders off. So I'm not wiping it off the table quite yet. Good boy. Good. So right there, I was able to catch his footstep. As soon as he thought about going off, I backed up and released. Good boy. I think this lead rope is gonna get in the way of everything with him. It's all right. I'm gonna reward for that. We walked away at the same time. It counts.
Try to get some sunshine.
Okay. You recording again?
Yeah.
We just stopped for a second because we're trying to make sure we get the best possible view we can. I have Camille helping me behind the camera right now.
Hi.
And I have them mic'd up. They can't hear you. Good boy. And I want to make sure you guys are really able to see him. And because of his coat color, it's a little bit darker in the shadow. So please bear with us as we're trying to make lighting work and also make what the horse is giving me already work. Good boy. I'm going to reward for that. I'm not going to turn my eye off of him when I release, just in case he decides he wants to draw in a little bit too quick. I tend to keep getting horses like that, so I wouldn't be surprised if he is one of those. Good boy. He thought about it. He thought about touching. I know. I'm sorry.
At least that'll keep them from running in and trying to
hurt you. That's true. So when he gets nervous, step in front of that line and then back up to draw in again.
We have more cloud cover now. Now it's all kind of the same plane of light.
Good boy.
But when the clouds parted and it was really like harsh sunlight, he just disappeared in the shadow.
He like builds up the courage when he's 2 or 3 feet away and then he gets a little backed off. He's like, yeah, I'm going to do it. Not quite so sure yet. So what I'm doing to kind of work through that is when I wait there for a little bit after he takes his steps forward, I wait for him to give a little bit of a sign of relaxation and then I release. Good boy. So what I'm looking for as far as relaxation is the head to lower, the eye to soften, the nostrils to get a little bit quieter with what they're saying. Good boy. Good boy. There we go. Good boy. That's the biggest thing right now when you're working with pressure and release, kind of in all aspects of training. First, you kind of wait for the horse's feet to either be quiet or be fluid, depending on if you're working on them standing still or going in a fluid motion. Good boy. And then you release, and then to build up from that and raise your expectations of your horse, you wait for relaxation before you release. That kind of falls true with gentling. Good boy. I have a feeling he's gonna be pretty friendly once I'm able to get a hand on him or two. I'm just gonna wait here. If he decides to leave, that's okay right now. I'll just step in front of his drive line. The reason I didn't try to back up or kind of release before he did there is because he was kind of on the brink of deciding to come up to me, and I didn't wanna completely rip that opportunity away if he did decide to come up to me. Now you see me kind of matching steps right here. And you can tell I'm getting closer and closer with that bubble with him. Ideally, right then, I would have taken a bigger step back. He was just a little too quick for me to read. Good boy. Good boy. I'm going to accept that because I think that's the closest I've gotten to him so far. Got a little bit too close into his bubble there. He wasn't quite ready for that. He's more ready for himself to build up that courage to approach me rather than me kind of get too close into his bubble. Good boy, we'll take it. Good boy. So I'm gonna stick to my hand right now. Another option if I wanna work on getting closer in that bubble without him building the courage up with more me putting some pressure on him is I would go back to the stick as an extension of my arm, and every single time I release, I would go another inch or two down on it. Good boy. I really want to get one touch out and reach for this first session. Or at least him kind of moving his neck out towards me to sniff. I'll take that. I'm pretty happy with that. Sweet. I'm gonna end that with him because I really, really like where his mind is at. He's not worked up. He's pretty calm. He's off of the rail right now, which I think is pretty big for a Mustang to be able to get worked off the rail pretty early on. We tend to kind of use the rail to our advantage as like a boundary on that side. And it's not a bad thing to do, but I think this confident personality and like the fact that his head is even lower right now and he seems pretty relaxed in his mind, I'm happy with that. I'd rather do like 3 sessions like that than 1 session where I get him like running around and a little bit more worked up. Yeah, I'm really happy with that one. So that's the end of our very first session, and I will see you guys in the next video.
Look at him. He's so cute. He's so cute. He's just standing there waiting. He's adorable.
Make sure you guys follow me on Facebook or check out my website because I did film maybe about 5 or 6 exclusive videos with my Mustang in addition to Camille and Ellen filming with their Mustangs for a initial Mustang gentling demo, and those videos will not be available to the public. This is just kind of a sneak peek at them and kind of shows you some of the stuff that I worked on. I think this is something that we may do again in the future. So if you are interested in seeing some more exclusive content, then make sure you reach out to me and just kind of stay up to date with the stuff that I'm posting on my other social medias. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and supporting my Mustang and I on this journey. And I hope you stay tuned for the next one.